So I want to show you how to make a gratin out of brie. So it's just really focusing on brie, and it brings together apples, you know, which in that case, I really recommend you use some apples that are not too sour, nothing like a Granny Smith, because it could be a bit too hard and a bit too sour. So something like a Pink Lady would be perfect, a Golden Delicious, because the sweetness and the softness of the apple needs to complement the cheese. And that sort of is an extra crunch. We put a little bit of sort of walnuts on the top, could be hazelnuts, and that will sort of add a little bit of bitterness as well, which is going to make that dish really nice. The one thing we will be using a lot in that dish is Calvados. Now, Calvados is a really interesting brandy. It's made from apples, so think of it like cognac. It's also done in a wooden barrel, that's why it's so brown. But it's made from apples that are sort of really specifically just grown in Normandy. And they're not your traditional eating apples, you know. Some of them would be really bitter, some of them would be really sour. Some of them would be really sweet, some are small as a cherry, other ones are really big. There could be up to 40 different varieties of apples in Calvados or cider, which Calvados is basically just distilled cider. And that makes the dish so unique. And with that dish, you know, the apples, the apple brandy, the walnuts, and the brie is sort of a real classic Normandy dish. And I hope you enjoy it, and it will be a lot of fun cooking it.
So let's start with the ingredients. And first ingredient are the apples. So make sure you get some really nice and juicy apples. If you sometimes buy apples in the supermarkets, they can be over a year, up to 2 years old. And they will be very chewy and very dry. The flesh will be very chewy and very dry, so that would not work in that dish. You need something that is quite juicy, fresh, and tender. So peel the apples and then cut them into wedges. And then remove the core and then cut them into smaller wedges. It's all about having the perfect look. So as you will see later when we arrange that dish, those wedges will come out really nicely. So you could do that in individual molds, but you could also go off and make one big mold if you want to do that, and basically place it in the middle of the table and then everyone can help themselves. So now my apple wedges are cut up. Next thing, heat the pan and then add some butter to the pan. Sort of let it all melt away. And once the pan is really nice and hot, and the butter sort of is just at the stage before it browns, so an ideal world, you create a little what the French call a beurre noisette, where you can see now that the butter turns slightly brown, and that's absolutely perfect because that will add an extra dimension of flavor to the dish. So then add the apples and then just sort of fry them in that butter, and because the apples should be nice and juicy, it will stop straight away the cooking process where the butter potentially could become too dark. And then add the Calvados. So if you can't get any Calvados, you can use some really, really good brandy. And what you want to do now is to basically cook away all the liquid from the Calvados so that the Calvados soaks, it's so that the apples soak up all the flavor from the Calvados. And that gives them just a unique flavor. And remember, Calvados is an apple brandy. So those two will be just matching up in the most delicious way. So just cook it until it's completely dry. That's very important because you don't want to have too much liquid. There will be a little bit of liquid at the end, which we can spoon over the cheese dish. That's not a problem. So use brie or camembert. It's up to you. Now, both cheeses are very similar, as I explained to you in another video, because they basically are almost identical. Where brie is usually made from double cream and camembert is just made from cream. So both would work in that dish, as long as they're nice and ripe. So I will make mine in some individual molds. So I just start layering in apples and cheese and apples and cheese. And try to arrange that as nicely as you can. And you could serve that as a cheese dish. You could serve that as an entree with some salad if you want to, or just with some baguette as a main course by itself. That's what I often do with it. Because it's very filling and it's just a great way. If you get a great piece of cheese, some really nice fresh apples, nice piece of bread, and if you're lucky, you have some calvados at home, or at least some brandy, a few nuts, and you can whip up an amazing dish. It goes brilliantly with a glass of really, really good red wine. So sprinkle over some nuts if you want to, walnuts, most authentic hazelnuts, pine nuts. And then the whole thing goes into the oven, and now you bake it. So we basically melt the cheese, the apples will soften even further, the nuts will brown up a bit. And you can see how nicely that bakes now after sort of around 10 to 15 minutes. So the next thing you do is you basically plate it up, some green salad, some bread. I turn the lights off, because that's the highlight of the dish, is that I add some calvados onto it and I set it alight, and that's how I would serve it on a cold winter night. It's an absolute perfect way of eating brie or camembert.
One last little fact I want to tell you about camembert. Camembert used to be slightish blue due to the climate of the Normandy region. It's only in 1910 when introduced a different bacteria to the mold, which made the cheese so beautifully white as it is today. So I look forward to seeing you next time, and happy cooking.